In this video, I'd like to demonstrate how to take a rehearsal recording or any other recording that's not recorded to a click and align it to the grid in Cakewalk by Bandlab. So what I have here loaded up in Cakewalk is a MP3 of a recording. It's just a rehearsal recording that my bandmate Addie and I did for a song that I wrote. He was singing and playing guitar. I was playing my cajon for the percussion part. And of course, we didn't record this to a grid. We just did it on the fly as a quickie recording. And what I want to do is demonstrate how to take this recording and align it to the grid here in Cakewalk. So the first thing I need to do is figure out exactly what the tempo of the final track is going to be. So in order to do that, I've got it loaded up here in VLC Player. So I'm going to play it in VLC, and then I'm just going to tap in the tempo in Cakewalk. Okay, so I think I'm going to go with 152, seems to be about the average, maybe a little bit on the slower side, but that's okay. And so I'm going to change the tempo of the session. So it changes the grid, but it won't change the tempo of the actual recording until we start aligning it. So just to demonstrate, I'm going to turn my metronome on for playback. And I'm going to turn snap off, and I'm just going to trim it up to the very beginning of the recording where the actual music starts. And I'm going to turn my snap back on, and I'm going to snap it to quarter notes. And I'm going to bring this in so that it starts at measure two. So now if I play it back, you'll notice that after the first few measures, the click ends up, or the music ends up drifting from the set tempo of 152. You hear that by measure 8 or 9 especially, it starts really drifting. So the way that we're going to align this is basically to split every single measure on the downbeat and then align and stretch the clips so that they match up with the grid. So in order to do that, I'm just going to zoom in a little bit here, and I can probably get this just a little bit tighter at the beginning. Turn my snap off. Press N on your keyboard to turn snap on and off. Pretty handy, especially for an exercise like this. So I'm just going to bring that in slightly. I'm going to turn my snap back on and put it right to the grid. So there's my next downbeat. I'm going to turn snap off, and then I'm going to hold down the Alt button and click on the clip to split it. Turn my snap back on. I'm going to take this right-hand clip and align it to measure 3, beat 1. And then with this clip, I want to stretch it so that it matches right up. In order to do that, I hold down Shift and Control and hover my mouse over the edge, and you get the little stretchy icon. And you just pull it so that it matches up with 3, measure 3, beat 1. And you know it indicates that it stretches that by 101%. So we move on. So there's the next downbeat. Turn my snap off, split at the downbeat, turn my snap on, move it to the grid, hold down Shift and Control, stretch it to the grid. And there's my next one. Snap off, split, snap on, move, and stretch. This one seems almost dead on 6, so I'm just going to leave that one the way it is. This one I'll split, snap back on, move, and stretch. Split that. Stretch. Split that. So now if I go back to the beginning, and you just have to go through it measure by measure throughout the whole song and repeat that process. And of course, you know, once you get the whole song done, then that can act as a sort of a template for a studio recording. You can do this, you know, if you have a live recording of your band or just a rough recording of anything being played along and you like the performance, but you just want to lock it in to use as a groove template and a grid template and a structural template for an actual proper recording. That's all I have for now. See you next time.